Things behind me. As the bus pulled into the Britannia Stadium, the huge crowd sitting and waiting in the rain roared their approval, but that was a roar drowned out by the reception the team got when they emerged onto the pitch. The message to manager and boardroom clear. Until that is resolved, Gudjon Thordarson and his captain Peter Handyside enjoyed their moment with 10,000 delirious supporters.
Well, Aston Villa stars of the future are just...
since I first arrived to Stoke. In between that, we once joined at Victory Down at Wembley, but now the real thing. On Saturday, we walked on as a second division club, but we came off as a first division team. I'm very headstrong and focused on what I'm after. But first and the last, I want to pay a great respect to you all and pay you a tribute for the great support that you have been to me and my team.
He's looking for a new job. Here's Daniel Pallett.
Starting for one final time, Gudjon Thordarson left Stoke this lunchtime clutching souvenirs of the club. Just 3 days ago, Thordarson and his players received a hero's welcome after they'd beaten Brentford in the playoff final. But he knew even then that his time in charge was nearing an end.
I tried to enjoy my moment, and for sure I did. I paid a great tribute to my supporters, and I waved them and clapped them. And more or less said goodbye to them.
On top of promotion, Thordarson has taken Stoke to three playoffs and won the auto windscreen shield at Wembley. The fans are stunned.
It's astonishing news, really. You know, the man's led us to promotion, which we so desperately craved, and 5 days later he gets the boot. It just doesn't make any sense. And from an entirely personal point of view, I think it's disgusting.
The chairman remains in Iceland, but a statement on the club's website says Thordarson doesn't appreciate the club's financial constraints. So while he drives off searching for a new job, Stoke City are now looking for their seventh manager in just 5 years.
Yeah, on the right has said there is no way that Thordarson will ever be allowed back to the Britannia Stadium, and he said that he will not be selling the club either. Well, meanwhile, the former England under-21 and Leicester City boss, Peter Taylor, has been ruled out as a possible replacement for Thordarson at Stoke. The Cheltenham Town manager, though, Steve Cottrell, now installed as the latest favourite to take over.
For the club, which sacked him last week, just days after gaining promotion to the First Division. Nick Clitheroe reports.
The supporters are angry. They can't believe the promotion was followed by the sack for Gudjon Thordarson. Hundreds turned out at the Britannia Stadium last night to back a campaign to reinstate the manager, as he hinted at plans to bring in a new set of owners for the club.
The chairman offered me his shares for sale here on Monday while the celebration was taking place. I told him at that time I didn't have the money to buy him out at that moment. I know some people up in Iceland as well. I'm quite well known there, and I know some influenced people. Maybe that could lead to something good.
It's 2.5 years since the Icelandic consortium took over at the Britannia Stadium and appointed the former national manager. The chairman, Gunnar Gislason, seen here at the time of the takeover, told us today that the issue of selling his shares did come up in conversation with Thordarson, but he's now ruled it out. The board claimed despite Thordarson's achievement in gaining promotion, they don't want to renew his contract because he doesn't appreciate the financial restraints on the club and has criticised them in the media. The fans aren't buying it.
We want Thordarson back in charge, or we want our money back for our season ticket. End of story.
They have the interests of Stoke City at heart, and they have always claimed since they joined the club that they listen to the supporters and they want it to be the club of the supporters. Then I hope that common sense will prevail and any personal difficulties will be set aside for the good of the club.
They're unlikely to get their way, though, and new manager is expected to be appointed next week.
The fans not getting their way there. Now, cricket.